2-0 against Barcelona, that wonderful goal that we've talked about many times already during this competition, that 24 passing move goal that put them in front. But by virtue of the fact they needed to win their last game, that's why they probably didn't make too many changes. But safe in the knowledge they're already into the next stage, they have made a few changes. And as we've already mentioned, Kato suspended after that red card yesterday. He will be available, though, for the next game. It's just a one-match suspension. Both teams going into their respective huddles, as is the want these days. There is a great team spirit among these young players. They all stay at the same hotel here, just down on the coast. Private beach, chance to jump in the sea. And for the players, of course, who aren't based in Qatar, that is a real bonus to come here and have nice facilities. And they dine together. The big ballroom is set up for all 12 teams to eat at the same time if they want. It gets very busy, as you can imagine, around meal times, but great spirit all the way. Alex Garcia Canedo is the Aspire Football Dreams coach, and probably one of the tallest goalkeepers in the competition is the Kashiwa Reysol goalkeeper, Leo Kakubo. Plenty of nations represented here by Aspire Football Dreams, and as we say, plenty of changes for Kashiwa tonight. Just the three for Aspire. Kashiwa Reysol in there, traditional all yellow. Kicking from right to left in the first half. We know all about their passing style. They really only know one style to play. It carries a little bit of flair. Something that works at junior level. Kashiwa finished 10th in the J-League last season, their main A team, so it doesn't necessarily carry through to the senior level. But certainly at this level, it is a very, very technical style. Just one thing that we noticed the last time they were here as well, the fullbacks, the centre backs rather, always look very comfortable on the ball. Early touch for Soyoda. Big and physical Spire Football Dreams. There's Carlos, the Costa Rican, coming forward. Good challenge there by the captain, Nakagawa. Straight away, Spire Football Dreams on the attack, and some more defending to do here. It's side footed away by Nakagawa. Can't get the ball clear though. Diallo. Great curling shot. Oh, what a goal! From Sumai to put a Spire Football Dreams in front. And the perfect start inside 2 minutes for the Aspire Football Dreams Academy. Nothing that Kakubo could do. He may be one of the tallest goalkeepers in the competition, but even at full stretch, he couldn't reach that. It's a wonderful finish. And we've seen some stunning goals here. Marco Sala's volley for Inter on the opening day. Not quite surpassed by that one, but that is a wonderful strike from Sumar. And he's put Aspire Football Dreams in front. What a start. They got off to a great start in their opening game. Led 2-0 against Benfica. To Sugai. Yamashita. Early crossing towards Nakamura, but well taken by the goalkeeper Manf. What a start. What a goal. Really was a stunning strike from outside the penalty area. A perfect start inside 2 minutes for Aspire Football Dreams.
Absolutely, didn't think it would be like that. I thought it might be a little bit more tighter. But what a strike and what a start for Aspire.
Played back to Manf under pressure from Nakamura.
Now all of a sudden it's Kashiwa. We've got to see what sort of their mental strength's like. Can they get back into the game? Don't think they expected this so early, but we know there's one thing, they play fantastic football. But the question mark is, do they create enough chances?
Well, making those six changes as well. Of course, they are safe in the knowledge. Even a defeat here would see them through to the next stage of the competition. So there isn't that pressure on that there was last year to try and get the result.
Good work down in the bottom left-hand corner. Just putting a bit of pressure on Aspire, trying to get back into the game now, Kashiwa.
They battled hard last night to get their opening win against Benfica.
I don't think they were happy at all with the sending off. You know, there's a big argument about it, whether it was should have been just a yellow. But either way, they tried to appeal. Nothing's come of that. So Kato still has the one match ban. So after this game, he's obviously can come back. But either way, they managed to come through it. You know, what do they say about when you got on to 10 men? It seems to bring you together, and it did do last night.
It happens such a lot, doesn't it? You see teams go a man down and all of a sudden they just raise that extra gear. I think it's the psychological factor that you just give that extra 10%. There's Yamada.
And you've got to say as well, it's a tough game as well for them. So is it going to pay some sort of... They've just given it away far too easy at the back there, but, you know, they're going to tire during the game. You know, they've not really had a lot of time to recover.
Diallo, pushed out wide again as Aspire Dream Academy football dreams come forward. Launched in 2007, the Aspire Football Dreams Academy. The latest edition of recruitment covered 16 countries across Asia, Africa and Latin America. It really does pull from a very good talent pool, doesn't it? And we saw Aspire International win here, of course, back in 2014. Great initiative.
Yeah, absolutely. And I just read there that, you know, they won in 2011 a Milk Cup, which is in Northern Ireland, against Manchester United, which they beat 5-1. Well, the Milk Cup has been around for a long time. It's a great tournament. They are breaking into the box now. Aspire ball goes too far ahead. Keeper comes out. I think it's a wonderful idea, this as well, going into some of these third world countries and finding the talent. There's so much talent playing around the world now. You know, you have to say one of them, for example, Yaya Toure and his brother. You know, there's talent there without a shadow of a doubt. It's good that Aspire are actually getting in there, finding these players. It just means so much to them, you see, and they've got that hunger. As easy what it was last night, then Kashiwa not having that time and space, they're pressing them in midfield, making it difficult.
All the way back by Salim Diaby from the Ivory Coast to his goalkeeper Manf. So some of the nations represented in Aspire Football Dream starting lineup here: Ghana, Senegal, Costa Rica, Guinea, Guatemala, Kenya. Really is pulled from, say, a lot of those countries. Forward by the Japanese captain Nakagawa. He's again Sonakagawa. Six changes tonight. The two centre-backs have stayed the same, though, Nakagawa and Okamoto. But there's only one change in the back four. Tanaka, the right-back, also retains his position. Change came at left-back. Toshiaki Miyamoto dropping down to the bench. I've got a substitute goalkeeper on the bench, the Japanese. Just six outfield players available to the coach. He can use five of those, of course, during the course of the match.
We did ask the question as well, because obviously the last time when they were here, they kept the same team all throughout. So they've answered that for us. They've managed to change it around a lot, freshen the legs up. Because they did, they struggled towards the latter part of the tournament.
Ball out towards Katana. He will bring the ball down under control. Players back inside. He's the goal scorer. Suma. Working the ball out nicely to the flanks here. Aspire. Oh, lovely little step over. Oh, just kicked the standing foot. That's a shame, because there was a lovely bit of skill in the build-up there from...
Once again, Suma, I love that crossfield. Once again, I love the crossfield ball from the left-hand side right out here to the right-hand side. You know, and it opens the play up. And as it comes out, then all of a sudden they switch it to the other side. They played it out to Niai. But a good positive start this year now by Aspire, taking a grip of the game, which I didn't think would happen. Thought Kashiwo would probably have too much football for them, but it's not been the case so far early in this game.
Ball played forward again, goes through Karamoko. Yamashita. Nakagawa given away again, a clumsy ball by the Japanese, which is unusual for them. Usually so efficient in their passing.
Played by Aspire, pushing men up, making it really difficult for them to play that flowing football, what we used to see from Kashiwa. That's what you do with the teams what like to play football, get everyone behind the ball. But now all of a sudden they've managed to thread it through.
Good ball forward by Yamada, breaks down though. Katana stopped in his tracks by that yellow defensive or midfield wall from Kashiwa Reysol. So very efficient, of course. This is Carlos, Costa Rican. Sully. Robert. Sully just put under pressure by Nakamura. All the way back to his goalkeeper, Manf. This will decide the winners of this group. And it's the final game in the group. Winners of the group will play the runners-up out of Madrid or Al Ahly. Al Ahly beating PSG earlier. They'll play tomorrow to see who wins their group. The runners-up will play the opposite team, so potentially mouth-watering fixtures. I'm sure both teams will want to avoid Real Madrid at this stage, although having watched Al Ahly, it's Madrid. In the Madrid players in the coach, or the coaching staff rather, in the crowd tonight taking a few notes.
The only thing there with Real Madrid, as good as what they were, can they play better than that? Can they maintain that? Can they? Because people are going to, the teams are going to know what they play like. They're going to nullify it. Have they peaked too early? No, they were very impressive. We'll have to see what happens when they're against a little bit more stiffer opposition.
Brolin. Carlos continues his run. Katana cutting back inside and managing to keep hold of the ball. Sumar. Brolin. Talk about how efficient the the Japanese are, even to the point where they're the only team I've seen before the game, the coaching staff walk around the far side of the field and put bottles of water all down the far side of the field. So they don't need to come to this side. They can actually grab refreshment if they're over on that side
organized.
Of the field.
Organised, absolutely.
Think of everything. Absolutely think of everything. Efficient is the word. Came here back in 2014. They drew 2-2 with Barcelona, as we mentioned, in their opening game. Beat Paris Saint-Germain 2-1. Lost out to AC Milan in the quarters. Then in the placings, 3-0 they lost to Manchester City, but then beat Aspire Qatar to clinch a seventh place finish, which was a respectable finish. We did expect more from them, having seen them play in their opening game against Barcelona.
Yeah, it's difficult in tournament football. It's about peaking at the right time, hitting form really at the right time. You know, they came in and they really did do well in the first couple of games, but just seemed to falter a little bit as it went on. Great ball on the outside. Can they lift it up? Good delivery. Well cleared by Aspire. Gone out for a corner to Kashua.
It's good defending by Sully, the big centre-back. Corner, though, for the Japanese. Trail by a goal to nil. That very early strike from Sumar. There's the difference between the two sides as it stands. Everybody bar two back inside the penalty area for Aspire. This will in swing in towards the goalkeeper Manf.
It's a good ball.
Good delivery. The goalkeeper had to palm that one away.
Great ball whipped in, really causing problems for the defence of Aspire. They managed to get a touch on it. It goes out for a corner the other side. Little touch there for the keeper. Actually, our coach there thought he was going to go into the far corner.
It'll be an outswinger this time from Hayata Sugai. Goalkeeper gets another hand on the ball but can only palm it away as far as Nakamura. Flip back in again towards Sokomoto, who'd come forward, and the referee spotted a foul, and that will relieve a little bit of pressure on Aspire, and it'll be a free kick. The Aspire coach, Alex Garcia Canedo.
Working out on the left-hand side, pushing forward. It's now a throw into Aspire. Football dreams on the left-hand side.
Defended by Tanaka. Just to win the ball and win the throw for his side.
All the preparation you do, and you come out early in the first half and you lose a goal, it changes things a little bit, but you've got to just keep believing, keep pushing on.
Yamada. Soyoda. Yamada. Good tackle by, or good footing rather, by Brolin. Sugai with a throw. Get the ball, goes out in the corner. It'll be an Aspire throw this time.
Yeah, just in the stand in front of us now, the coach of Al Ahly coming up. Just meeting all the representatives. Delighted with the result, and rightly so. What a performance they produced in the game just before this, beating Paris Saint-Germain.
In case you missed the action today, the first game saw Celtic come from a goal down to beat the Argentinians Estudiantes 2-1. And as Nick just mentioned, a fine 3-0 win for Al Ahly against Paris Saint-Germain, who conceded 7 goals in their 2 group games, and the defending champions defending their title with barely a whimper, it's fair to say.
Yeah, it's a big result, huge result. That's the shock of the tournament for Mal Ali.
So free kick to Aspari. It'll be Brolin to whip this one over. Sully's come forward on the edge of the penalty area. Carlos is there as well. Everybody back behind the ball for Kashiwa. Headed away by Yamada. Robert. Katana. Get the yellow shirts standing firm.
There's a shot there, well blocked. Spire there, the ball spins out for a corner, so it's a corner for Spire. Still leading this game 1-0. Coming up to 20 minutes on the clock.
More defending here to do for the Japanese. And this will in swing down towards Leo Kokubo. Plenty of height on the ball, good punch by the goalkeeper. Only as far as Sumar. Too much luck that time for the goal scorer, finding a way through with his shot. Slid out wide by Diallo. It's Brolin trying to get the ball past those yellow shirts, but they formed a pretty good defensive block.
Looking sharp, looking up for the game tonight, Aspire. You know, they've set up perfectly to make it difficult for Kashua. Obviously coming out and getting the goal, but either way, they're looking good. Taking control of the game, really. Playing the better football than Kashua, if you like.
Well, they'll have been bitterly disappointed, Aspire, to have let a two-goal lead slip against Benfica.
Yeah, and I think I spoke to the coach yesterday, and he just said, you know, because what they were doing is they have to be disciplined at the back as well. As well as being good and inventive going forward, be disciplined at the back. So I expect that in this game.
Tomorrow, by the way, the final day of the group games tomorrow promises to be fascinating because we've got five winners out of six teams in action tomorrow. Al Ahly taking on Real Madrid in the opening game. Aspire Academy taking on Inter Milano. And then Estudiantes, who were beaten by Celtic, the only losers, taking place tomorrow against FC Red Bull Salzburg, who impressed us with their opening performance against Celtic a couple of days ago. That's all tomorrow's action. For now, our attentions are on this one. Aspire Football Dreams leading Kashiwa Reysol by a goal to nil.
Again.
Relatively new side by modern standards, Kashiwa Reysol. When you think Celtic were formed at the late end of the 1800s, 1940, Kashiwa Reysol have been in operation. Missed an Englishman among their former managers as well, Steve Perry.
I know. I can't believe you just jumped in there. I was just going to have a little rustle around, then and come up with some bits of information.
Do you know who's currently in charge of Kashiwa's first team?
I'll tell you in a minute.
Okay. I'll leave that with you for a moment while you page the Oracle. Brolin's header.
Yeah, Martin Mendes is in charge at the moment.
Milton Mendes.
Steve Perryman as well, ex-Tottenham Hotspur captain. What a blast he was from the past there, so.
Still down at Exeter City, I believe.
Is he still there?
He's a sporting director, yeah. Paul Tisdale, who's one of the longest serving managers in English football these days, behind Arsene Wenger, I believe.
Right, brilliant. I think they think a lot. I mean, I remember playing down there a long time ago. Great little pitch down there, and I think it's all changed. So, you know, it's good to hear that when you have a manager what's been there a long time. It's not the type of thing what we're used to, is it? In the modern day game, there's a lot of changing.
Injury here too. Katana. So there will be a brief stoppage in play.
I've been reading in the newspapers as well today, Mourinho is ready for coming back.
Where do you think he'll go?
It's looking like Manchester United. There's a lot of talk about that, but I think we're going to have to watch this space.
Promises to be an interesting close season, I think, in the Premier League. A lot of people talking about maybe Pellegrini going to Chelsea when he leaves Manchester City, which is interesting.
It absolutely is. It's going to be a lot. It's going to be a bit of a merry-go-round there. But either way, I would imagine that Mourinho will be back in the Premier League.
It's not like he needs the money, though, is it? I think he's just so enthusiastic about getting back.
No, he just wants to get it right, doesn't he? He wants to, you know, it didn't go right for him at the end at Chelsea, but he wants to get back in.
Anyway, to use your analogy, we've seen the Leicester City of this tournament a little earlier on today.
Absolutely, yeah. You know, and that's what the breath of fresh air is. That's what the breath of fresh air is for the fans. You know, these youngsters like we're watching now, we want to see these coming through. We want to see them playing in the first team. It's not all about spending money. It's about seeing these. There's nothing more rewarding than seeing a player coming through the ranks and, you know, furthering his career and eventually playing for his country. And that's what they're all trying to do. But it's difficult, you know. You have to be honest with them and harsh with them. Like I was, what I said with Celtic in the first half, it was nowhere near good enough. They had to show a bit of character. And they did do that second half, so hopefully they kick on from there. Celtic, you know, you put a shirt on like Celtic, it's a massive history. You know, you've got to have pride, you've got to have a bit of passion, and they showed us that second half. So,
just wondering whether they had your analysis on in the dressing room at half time. Maybe it was the team talk that they that inspired them.
It just got, you know, they just got going. Little things in a game could just get you, just get things going. It just gives you a little bit of confidence, and you know, they've got that belief now.
Back in play once again. It's a foul. It's a niggly foul by Sumar. So the final day of group matches tomorrow, the knockout stages will begin to take shape. Don't forget, you do play for place, as we've mentioned a couple of times in this competition. So despite the fact that Paris Saint-Germain and Shanghai are finishing bottom of their groups, they will still play another game to determine which position they finish. At the moment, that will be 11th and 12th. The other two bottom teams will contest 9th and 10th, and then we're into quarter-final territory.
We're getting into the business end of it. A lot of big, big games ahead. It's not let us down at all. It's been wonderful standards so far to watch these players. Under 17s, good mixture of under 16s players as well. And everyone doing the right thing and playing some wonderful football.
That's a poor back pass by Diaby, and Manf just managed to get the ball away. Just a little lacking concentration there by the Aspire team, and they might still have some more defending to do.
Oh, great tracking, well done. Putting the pressure on. Well done, Aspire.
Yamada. All the way back to his goalkeeper, Kokubo. Okamoto. Again by Okamoto, came off the captain.
The only question mark with Kashiwara is very good at playing football, lovely passing, but do they create enough opportunities? Have they got that real cutting edge? I think they get to a certain point, you can, you know, if you defend properly, you can nullify it. You know what pace Aspire have got going forward as well, very dangerous. So they can very quickly be defending and hit it on the counter-attack.
Good play by Karamoko over on that far side too. Gives off a little bit of ground, throw in by Robert to Sully. Salim Diaby. Ball searching for Katana, but comfortably cut out that time by Sugai. Yamashita. Sugai. quite happy to play the ball back, Kashiba. We noticed that 2 years ago. They're never in a rush to get the ball forward if there's nothing on. They do like to keep possession.
And that can come a little bit predictable sometimes. At the moment now, if you're looking at Aspire, you're happy with them. You get them playing in front of you, get men behind the ball, they'll go backwards, they'll go into the middle. If you just look here now, backwards again. You know, at the moment that's okay for Aspire. They're just pushing it forward. Can you get to him? Try and force it on the outside. Good play again from Aspire. Just getting the ball there, knocking it out. So everything's played in front of you. There's men behind the ball. You know, they've got to move the ball quickly. They have to be a lot more direct. Once again, moving across, just going up with the scenario, moving to the side. They're not getting anywhere where they're going now, you see. It's hard work for Aspire, but they've got to stick with it. They've got to work hard. They've got to talk to each other. Got to be organised. Not going out of, you know what I'm trying to say there? They're not going anywhere now, so they're not really affecting anything.
I think that's probably one of the stats that we talk about possession, and that's where it becomes a slight anomaly, because it's quite obvious looking at this at the moment that Kashiwa probably will have had the most possession in the first half, but at the moment they're trailing by a goal to nil, so it doesn't really matter if you don't do anything with it. Here come Aspire looking for a second! And it deflected wide. It was a good effort from Andrei, but he couldn't find a way past those yellow-shirted defenders who surrounded him in numbers.
Now, this is the way they've got to play it. Absolutely perfect. Andrei there, you know, he does really well. A lot of yellow shirts around him. Gets his shot in, but just skews it wide. But you've got to hit them on the counter-attack. Be patient. Let them play in front of you. Get men behind the ball. You know, they're not going to hurt you. Some of the biggest teams in the world struggle when everybody's behind the ball. So what they're doing at the moment, doing totally the right thing, but hit them on the break and use that pace.
Well, now Kashiwa go long, taking the direct route. Oh, it's almost a brilliant pull down by Nakamura. The offside flag went up. He ran from a lot deeper than that. First instinct wasn't that he wasn't offside, and he's not offside.
No, he's not at all. But once again, now that's good play that from Kashiwa. All of a sudden, you think they're playing all the time, just knock a long ball there, just to stretch the game, and then you can get back to playing your football. Just a straight ball over the top then, and he nearly gets in. So a bit more of that, probably. You know, you don't want to be predictable, you know, you just got to... And it took a spy by a bit of a surprise then, with a ball over the top, and they were nearly in.
He's got good pace, Nakamura. And he brought that down under control. I thought for a second he managed to drag it down, but the flag had gone up anyway. Sully, central defender for Spire Football Dreams. Plenty of space out on this near side for Katana, who's just hugging in this touchline. Sugai, who's playing as left back, look how far he's tucked in, right in the centre of the field there. And if the ball does come out to Katana,
yeah, but just look,
so much space.
Just look where he is there now, Katana. It's a wonderful option to do that. Get as wide as possible. Look, they're going to look at it. Can he hit the pass? Now all of a sudden it's a little bit too late because all the Kashiwa players come over. Can they switch it again the other side? It's something what they're looking for.
Down the line by Diaby towards Carlos, but he can't keep the ball in play. Will flick off the Costa Rican and go behind for a throw, or go out for a throw rather, right down in the corner. This day three of 11 of the Alcas International Cup 2016. Fifth edition of the tournament.
Felix!
Has the potential to be one of the best we've seen as well, judging by the opening 3 days' play. Robert. That's good persistence by the fullback. Two defenders around him. He hasn't given it up, and he goes down now and wins a free kick for his side. Great play.
Well done. Just 30 minutes moving on the clock there now. It's a good foul to give that. You know, just two players there, tries to go through the middle of them. Might have been a bit harsh, really, for a foul, but either way, just get that little bit of a breather, just get organised. Once again, we talk about these set pieces. You know, you're leading 1-0, it's a glorious opportunity to make it 2 just before half time. Actually, a big nose and big defenders in there. It's a right footer, it's got to go to that far post, whip it in, put pace on it as you can.
Well, everybody's back behind the ball for Kashiwa. That's rolled out short to Diallo. Well, they haven't got that one right, Aspire. And now there might be a break on here. That's a lovely ball. Goalkeeper's a long way out here. He'll come all the way across and get there before Nakamura. Although he's put his central defenders under a little bit of pressure. But it's a free kick that didn't work, that almost cost Aspire at the other end. Fortunately, the goalkeeper was a long way off his line. Managed to sweep up.
Yeah, he was tempting fate a little bit then when the ball came out. You know, we nearly got caught in it. They got away with it, though, Aspire. They took the short corner, got caught out. Kashua nearly made something happen from it.
Nakagawa. They will be wary of the pace that Nakamura possesses, Aspire. There he is again, he's just nestled in between the two central defenders at the moment. Lovely ball threaded through to Yamada. Here is Nakamura. Tracked by Sully. Tsuyoda. Yamashita. Good play once again by Kashiwa holding possession, but even better play by Aspire, who got two solid banks back behind the ball, and they've ended up back in their own half again, those in yellow. Nakagawa. Ondera. To Keita Mori. Now the fullback, Tanaka. Oh, that's a good play. That's a foul. Surely referee plays the advantage, but they're a man short over on that far side at the moment, and I think Mori might need some treatment. And they've lost the advantage now. I just wonder whether the free kick might have been the better option there, although they did have possession. Wasn't too much of an advantage. And it is a yellow card. That's Robert who gets the yellow.
Just catches him. As bad as what it actually looked, but he just catches him, just left his foot in.
He's okay, doesn't need treatment, so he won't need to go off the field. Be a throw into Aspire. I'm sure they will just give the ball back to Kashiwa, but it'll end up all the way back with the goalkeeper when they're in a decent position. With Kakubo, the goalkeeper. Now the captain, So Nakagawa. Yamashita. On by Nakamura. Mori, who's not the worst for his knock a moment or so ago. Good overlap here from Tanaka. Good challenge from Robert, who has to get his tackles right now, having been booked a moment or so ago.
Very good tackle.
No quarter. Man and man.
Yamashita.
Up.
Sugai. Mori. Tanaka. Good play again from Kashiwa. Cross too deep though. I remember someone saying, when you talk about football, it's not what you do sometimes when you've got the ball, it's what you do when you haven't. And that's what Kashiwa are very good at, finding those little spaces to play the balls into.
They are, but in this game here now, I think Aspire is set up perfectly. They've got the buffer of the one-goal lead, but they're set up, they're working hard for each other. Kashiwa will have a lot of possession, but it's whether they can really hurt them. They've managed to get in just a few times, slide a few balls through, but nothing's really come of it.
Sully. Yellow. Bounced up just in front of the goalkeeper. Kakuramoko.
Yeah, but well done. No, it's good positive play. Getting at the defence of Kashiwa, then getting a shot in. Now's a chance when it opens up for them then. Offside's been given though.
Nakamura, the player that's flagged once again. Too sure, is he offside? Too sure he was.
I don't know what he's saying. Don't know what he's saying. Sometimes I don't know what the linesmen say. You know, all you've got to do is just look across a line. It can't be that hard, really. I know the game's a lot quicker, but sometimes it just baffles me how they make some of the decisions.
I think that's twice Nakamura can feel himself a little unfortunate to have been flagged offside. Can Kashiwa get themselves back into this one before half time? They've got 6 minutes to do so. Reminder that the Japanese side are through. A point will be enough to see Spire football dreams through as well. It will leave Benfica at the bottom of the group with just a point. It's Diallo well challenged. Good strong challenge, really tussling away. And well, that's a poor mistake. Diallo might get a second chance. Diallo's shot always rising high over the top, but having got the tackle in, Kashiwa presented the ball straight back to Aspire.
Yeah, well done. Good play. Good foot battle in midfield. And as a ball, they get up. No problem. Good battle. You can just see it there now. Then all of a sudden, just nicks the ball. It just opens up. There's a strike, but just doesn't really make the keeper work. Nothing wrong with that as well there, referee. A bit of physicality in midfield there. There's your tap of nurse. It was a right decision, referee. Just looked like it was a bit of a two-footer there, though, but I just thought he might have connected with the ball, and he didn't.
Yeah, it was Diallo who had the shot a moment or so ago that gave away the free kick. Good ball over the top. Flags up again, though, against Scioda this time.
Something what they've got to look at a little bit more, that ball over the top.
Yeah, that one's off. Just give that one to the linesman. We still call them assistants? We call them linesmen again. More linesmen.
We'll go back to linesmen.
Yeah. They don't assist very much, do they?
No.
Assistant referee. It's the Kashiwa coach, Takanori Unobe.
It's a play down at the moment for Aspire.
Well, there's that argument as to whether Kashiwa should be playing the ball out. At the moment they haven't. Now it has gone out, but I'm not too sure that's what Nakamura meant to do. It's Karamoko that's gone down injured, maybe just taken a knock on the ankle.
Cramp again
before half time. I'm not too sure that was, maybe.
I don't think that's cramp. He looks like he just twisted it slightly.
Yeah. Well, we're back in play. No treatment needed once again. Coming to the final stages of the first half. Spire football dreams got off to a wonderful start. Fine goal by Sumar from distance beyond the clutches of Leo Kokubo in the Kashiwa goal. Kagawa. Well, that's given away chance here for Andrei. Still going. Nakagawa comes across and got a big chunk of the player despite the fact he's conceded the corner. Referee tells him to get back to his feet.
Yeah, good defending, great defending. The one-on-one corner by the big guy there. Makes the challenge. Tries to get on the outside of him there. Has to time it properly. He just caught it as he's going down, didn't mean to do it. There you go, he tries to get his balance, his arms out there. He just, I think he gets a lot on his thing that he could do about it, just trudging him as he's coming down. But good defending by the big guy that did really well.
Abdullah Jabba Almari is the referee, by the way. All the officials Qatari based in this competition. So it is a corner to Aspire, but they've only got 10 players on the field to attack this one at the moment. Again, it's played out back to Diallo. Has to be offside. There's a little flick over the top, but the whistle had already gone. Karamoko was offside by quite some distance then. I don't think there was too much doubt about that one. You can see two of them there coming out. And, well, that's probably as blatant an offside as you'll see in this tournament. Mori. Chance for Kashiwa then straight away at the other end. Tanaka. Yamashita. Let it go early and was caught late. And it's another free kick to Kashiwa Reysol. One or two clumsy challenges just creeping in at the moment. No real need for the follow through on the challenge. It's Diallo.
Yes! Robin, what do you want to say? Man, here, call us!
Five Kashiwa players on the edge of the penalty area. Everybody bar one back for Aspire. They've just left Karamoko up just in case there's a quick break here. So two defenders staying back on the halfway line. Needs a good delivery. Gets a good delivery as well. Only half dealt with by Carlos. Referee's whistle gone. It's another offside against the Japanese. I think it might have been Nakamura once again. He's just gone a fraction too early. It was the central defender, in fact, Okamoto, that was judged offside. See the flag up straight away on the far side. So 2 minutes additional time at the end of the first half. It's been a first half that hasn't really got going. Spire started exceptionally well, but they've been unable to capitalise on their early goal. Kashiwa just steadied things down, and while having the lion's share of possession, haven't really caused Manf in the Spire goal too many problems. Nakagawa. Carlos, almost nicked off his toe by Soyoda. Diaby. One last chance maybe for Aspire, right on the stroke of half time. Another great shot from Sumar once again, on a tip over by Kakubo. And that could have been a second stunning goal from the Aspire number 8. Hit it first time. Goalkeeper got a fingertip to it. Great save, great shot, good football all round from both sides. What a save that is. Right on the stroke of half time. Good agility shown by Leo Kakubo. Concentration needed here for Kashiwa right at the end of the first half. Looks like Aspire going to take the corner short. Well, they've wasted the opportunity. We were right at the end of added on time in the first half, and they've wasted the opportunity in the end to get the ball into the box. But what a start it was for Aspire Football Dreams. Just 2 minutes gone when Halasan Sumai fired in from long range beyond Kakubo. And right at the end of the half, he had another chance, which was tipped over by the goalkeeper. Kashiwa controlled the possession, but haven't really created too many chances, and they'll need to put that right in the second half. They are through, don't forget. Aspire need to win here to guarantee their place in the next stage of the competition. A point, though, would be enough, as we say, with Benfica going out. Halfway point, it's Aspire Football Dreams 1, Kashiwa Reysol 0.
انضم إلى برنامج Global Recognition من أوائل QNB وتمتع بعالم من الخدمات المصرفية المميزة، خدمة عالمية تقدم لك امتيازات حصرية تعزز نمط حياتك أينما كنت وفي أي وقت، تجعلك تتحكم في معاملاتك وحساباتك، تمكنك من امتلاك منزل جديد في الخارج مع خدمة التمويل العقاري الدولي. برنامج Global Recognition من أوائل QNB عالم الامتيازات الحصرية.
لما أكبر أصير نفس نيمار. في 2022 أبي أكون في استاد البيت.
عم نشوف يعني جمهور في ملعب اللاعبين.
كأس العالم 2022 هو البداية.
For nearly 40 years, Musco has specialized in the design and manufacture of sports and large area lighting solutions. From neighborhood ball fields to international speedways, Musco is committed to providing cost-effective lighting solutions and services you can rely on. For your budget, for the environment, Musco Lighting, we make it happen.
مع بيبسي يلا ناو.
نجم المفضل، واحد من أكثر اللاعبين موهبة في بلاد. اليوم الموهبة بروحها ما صارت تكفي، الكرة تغيرت في مكان تقدر تحصل فيه مستوى تدريب عالمي يحفزك، تعطي كل ما عندك، يساعدك بالعلم تبني مستقبلك، وبالعلوم الرياضية تطور أدائك، وفيه دائماً في دائرة أمينة. هذا المكان اكتشفني وأنا حاضر. ودي أصير بيوم من الأيام نجمه المفضل.
أكاديمية أسباير، اليوم حلم وغدا نجم.
هل تعلم أن شبكة بي إن تقدم تشكيلة متنوعة من البرامج لكل العائلة؟ أحدث الأفلام والمسلسلات والبرامج الترفيهية وأفضل البرامج الوثائقية والإخبارية وبرامج الأطفال. وأقوى الفعاليات الرياضية الحصرية. كما يمكنك مشاهدة هذه البرامج في أي وقت وأي مكان. وهل تعلم ما هو سعر الاشتراك؟
You need to smile.
أليس هذا مدهشاً؟
Half-time in our final match of day three of the Alcas International Cup 2016. Aspire Football Dreams 1-0 up against Kashiwa Reysol. Two excellent footballing sides. Nick Summerby back in the studio alongside Chris Makin with me here, both Alcas analysts. Of course, Chris, two good footballing sides.
Yep.
Both passed the ball well, but you've noticed that there's a little bit of difference in the style.
Just a little bit. I think Aspire have a little bit more individual flair, players that can make an opening during the match, whereas Kashiwa are the ultimate footballing team, really. The way they pass the ball about, great movement, but they're a real team. I just think Aspire have more individuals that can create an opening.
Yeah, yeah, but Chris, Kashiwa, have they got the end product? Playing wonderful football, side, backwards.
Yeah.
But can they finish a team off?
I'm not going to go off tonight because they've made six changes to the team. So both teams have made changes.
Listen, they
can see these two teams meeting later on in the competition.
They certainly had the end product against Benfica.
Yeah, they did. But I just think the way Aspire are up against them now are doing everything perfectly. Yeah. They're just getting men behind the ball. They're going from side to side. Nothing at all. All of a sudden, nicking it when they get the opportunity and hitting them with the break. They're just set up really well for this now. It's a mature performance by them.
They couldn't have got off to a better start, Aspire Football Dreams. The goal coming very, very early on in the game, just in the second minute there, Chris.
Yeah, Suma with a wonderful strike. This is what I'm talking about. People that can do something different. I tell you what, that's unbelievable. It looks even better now. He knows exactly what he's doing. Great first touch out of his feet. And normally you get a little bit of spin on the ball. That just flies into the top of the net.
I've just started compiling top goals of the tournament. That's obviously in there, isn't it?
It won't beat Salah. Salah's is still number one for me.
Hang on.
That's a strike, that. Have you thought of one which could beat that now?
No.
Not yet. There's a long way to go in the tournament. Let's look at this chance here. Sticking with the Aspire Football Dreams. Nick, Chris and I were down on the touchline watching this. Ndri, he's so quick.
This is why it suits him, the game, what I've just said there, is they can hit them. And he does wonderful, you know. He beats the player so easily there, and he's just waiting for that bit of space. And it was good defending as well. They just put him off. But this is a strong point, this. This is where...
Well, I got to admit, you say it was good defending.
Okamoto, watch Okamoto here. Keep him down the line. Andre's all left foot. Keep him down the line, away from goal.
What you're saying is they've closed him down in the end. They've all come in the end to put him off his...
But if we just go back there, just look at his skill, how he drags it back. He's going forward, and he gets his foot. He really does well just to move it back, what makes it difficult. Yep. But, you know, that's where the dangerous. Just sit there, be patient, and hit them on the counter-attack.
They look very similar to the side that won here 2 years ago, don't they?
Yeah.
For me.
But I think they've learned a little bit. They've made changes tonight to rest the legs, but they're up for it, this tournament. They're going to get stronger. But I just think my question mark with them, it's all good with the football.
No, I'm talking about Aspire. They look exactly like the team from 2 years ago.
They both do, but obviously improved a little bit.
The man leading Kashiwa Reysol, Nagakawa, the captain. Chris, you've singled him out as a...
I think he's a wonderful
great player.
Look at this. This is a centre-half. It's a fantastic pass. I mean, it gets given offside. But he's got that passing ability. He's a leader. I'm looking at the defensive line of Kashiwa. And it's the absolute total opposite to Paris Saint-Germain. They all know what they're doing, and they're led by that man there.
And by the way, he's not far off. He's only just off,
He's just pinged that forward, hasn't he?
And
this is him. His own penalty earlier. Times it to perfection. Keeps the ball going away from goal. But he's a wonderful talent and a real leader at the back as well. Look at that. Steps in and makes a valuable tackle there. And he had to do it because it was in his own box.
I feared for it then. I thought, because he's got a good trick up his sleeve here. you know, and he's much smaller than what he is, and he does a bit of shape, but he keeps up with him, uses his strength, and gets his tattling.
Just one more opportunity I want to show you. Just Suma's shot right at the end, actually, of that first half.
Yeah, he just seems to drop off, doesn't seem to make the space. Once again, he's got a picture in his head. We'll talk about these players at 17 years old. It's so important that they get into good habits at this age. And straight away, he knows what he's going to do, doesn't he, Nick?
Yes, he does, yeah. And it just shows that the goal, what he scored, wasn't a fluke at all. Yeah. It's a wonderful bit of skill, difficult bit of skill. And he's got it absolutely perfect. And the keeper just gets that fingertip. You know, and the dangerous, and it is a very equal game with a lot of talent out there. You've got to realise how old they are, and they're doing everything right, and they're maturing, and they're looking good.
OK, just one goal between them at the moment. Let's have a look at it one more time in a little more detail. Chris, do you want to take us through this?
Yeah, it's just, I keep saying about Suma, and he's had a couple of opportunities where he's just got that picture in his head. I mean, look at the defensive shape there of Kashiwa. They'll probably be happy for him to shoot from there. What is it? 31 metres. Wow. First touch out of his feet. And normally you see a little bit of whip on the ball going into the far post, but he catches it and it just flies past the goalkeeper, who's a very, very good goalkeeper, by the way.
He's got no draw, but he's not stepping back two yards. He just hits it. But if you stood where he was in the pitch, you think, no way. He's not going to be able to do it from there because you can't see anything. He's obviously hit it with so much pace. He's obviously a couple of yards wide and he's just caught it perfectly. So it looks a lot easier than what it actually is difficult. He wouldn't dream of doing it really from there, especially with no run-up.
So Nick was questioning whether they have the end product. They need to find it in this second half. I know they've made it through anyway. Yeah. But obviously I'm sure they'd like to finish top of the group.
They will do. I think that's the only thing missing from their performance in the first 45 minutes. No end product. They passed it well. Movement's been good. Technical ability is high. Defensive shape without the ball is very good. Just need a goal or two, maybe one or two goals.
I'm just wondering whether he'll make changes in the second half. We saw him make quite a few changes against Benfica.
He's not going to make too many this tournament, is he? Never made one.
Well, I know he's gone totally the other way 2 years ago, didn't he?
Yeah, bringing everyone off.
Well, it is totally the opposite. But
Do you know what I liked in that situation when they knocked a long ball? It just changed it for that little bit of a, you know, just for something different there. Just try looking at it. Nearly got in as well. It's only a straight pass, so maybe just look at that. But when you watch them play, wonderful what it is. They get to a certain point and they seem to run out of ideas because Aspire are making it difficult for them. So they have to show us that little bit of something. It's, you know, that bit of, when I say an end product, you know, let's see if you can carve something open.
Oh, I'm just sorry, I just caught a glimpse in. I thought the players were sort of ready to go. But
you were ready to go.
They are. No, it's the officials that are late coming out.
It's not. It's back to all right. You better get used to it. QSL's back shortly.
Thank you very much. Okay, Nick will make his way back to the commentary booth. You can see, look, the referee's on his way in there. And it's a perfect time for match commentator Mark Tompkins to pick up.
Thanks, Rod. Team's back out already for the second half. As you say, unusually, we were waiting for the referee on that occasion, but he is now back, Abdullah Jabir Al-Mahri, and we are ready to go for the second half. It's Aspire Football Dreams, all in grey, kicking from right to left in the second half. Can't miss Kashiwa Reysol in that bright yellow kit. They're probably the only team that doesn't need to bring a spare kit to this tournament. Nobody else playing here in yellow. Probably keeps the hotel laundry quite busy, which is seen as they played yesterday as well. Long ball forward by Sully, but straight through to the goalkeeper, Leo Kakubo. Reminder, Kashiwa Reysol already through to the next stage of the competition. A point would see Aspire Football Dreams join them at the expense of Benfica. Benfica currently propping up the group. This is the third match of three today. Three more games for you tomorrow in the final group stages. We'll know the final positions in our quarter-final lineups at the end of tomorrow. Five of the six winners from their opening games all in action tomorrow as well. It should be another fascinating day's action. And it really has been a wonderful tournament so far here at Aspire Zone. Takanori Nunobi, the Kashiwa coach, already on his feet at the start of the second half. He'll certainly be looking for a response from his team, having gone behind to that early goal. Did notice the possession stats at half-time. They didn't have the most of the ball in the first half, Kashiwa. It was Aspire Football Dreams that had 52% of the possession. It felt like Kashiwa had the ball for the majority of time, but they've started in possession at the start of the second half. To Nakagawa. Forward by Okamoto. Four yellow shirts along the edge of the penalty area. Plenty of options on for the Japanese at the moment. Yamashita. Overlap here from Sugai. Good challenge from Carlos, the Costa Rican. Did that go out of play? Did go out of play, and it's the first corner of the second half. So early pressure for the Japanese at the start of the second half, and some early defending here for Aspire. Matt, for the goalkeeper, just trying to sort his side out. They're all back bar one. They've left us Karamoko up in the centre circle. Needs a good delivery, this, from Hayate Sugai. Five players in the centre, all going in different directions. It's a good header away by Sully. It's Sumar onto Katana. He's got options on in the centre. Andrei looking to find a little bit of space, but the ball doesn't quite pick him out.
Well done by Sumar then. Brilliant bit of play, just getting the ball, extending himself out, really pushing into the space, you know, and then all of a sudden he tries a crossfield ball, but it doesn't quite work out. It's a big example there of what to do there. If the space is there, really drive your way through into it, push into it.
Muratala Quadri is about to come on for Aspire Football Dreams. So Alex Garcia Caniedo making a change right at the start of the second half. You know, I've noticed as these days have gone on, we've reached day three, it's taking you longer to get back from the studio each time.
Have you noticed
that? Are you slowing down?
Have you noticed I was rapid at the start, and all of a sudden it's like a slow plod?
Anyway, you made it.
So
that's the main
stairs, isn't it? Those.
It's quite a long walk, actually. It could be worse, especially when we're on the other pitch. But
yes,
not too bad at the moment.
It is slowing down, you're right.
Oh, well, long way to go yet. We're only 3 days in. Well, we're now going to see the substitution. So Muratala Quadri, who's one of the standout players for Aspire Football Dreams in their opening game, is coming on. And it's Karamoko, the number seven from the Ivory Coast, that's coming off. I always find it quite strange that coaches do that. You think they make the change at half-time, why give it 2 or 3 minutes? It doesn't really seem long enough to see what you talked about works unless there's some kind of injury being picked up.
Unless there might be something, they're probably just having a little bit of a look to see how it is for the first couple of minutes. Good sense of real close team spirit there. I saw them just before they were warming up, and they all get together, have a bit of a cuddle. And they all, you know, every player that comes off gets a cuddle from the manager, and they all pretty close, good team spirit.
Well, I suppose the good thing about this level of football is that some of these players, when they've been at academies of long time, may have been together for sort of 3 or 4 years already. So, and a lot of these academies, I know Red Bull Salzburg, the players actually live at the academy apart from the ones that actually are from Salzburg. So they're actually together, they school together, they're still in education, a lot of these players. So it is like a close-knit family, and that has to breed good team spirit.
Yep, it's got to. You know, it's got to, yeah, definitely. I think even with a lot of the Aspire lads there, they're from a long way away, so you get very pally, don't you, when you team up with somebody, you know, or when you team up with a couple of players. Yeah, it's all about the team spirit. You know, I do talk a lot about Leicester City, who were top of the Premier League. I mean, there's no more of a bigger example than that team spirit and fighting for each other. You know, and that's I sense that with Al Ahly, what we watched today, and obviously I sense that with it with Aspire here. The only way you're going to do it is a team working hard together. Obviously, if you've got players in there with that bit of flair, well, that, you know, that's an added bonus.
Shewa have won themselves a free kick in a dangerous position. They're going to make a change themselves. The Japanese, they're bringing on Riko Ochai. See who it is that's coming off. It's Yuto Yamada that will make way. So both teams have made a change right at the start of the second half. Five substitutions allowed during the course of the match, don't forget, should they be required. It does give the coaches chance to rotate things around with so many games in so few days. Once again, Kishiwa have seven players on the edge of the penalty area. Not a great delivery. Missed out the first man, though. As Diallo couldn't get ahead on the ball, and now the break is on for Ndrai. Quadri, the substitute, just come on. Can he have an immediate impact? He hurdles the challenge. Might have been unlucky not to get a free kick there, but Kashiwa have defended it well. Yamashita. Mori, that's switched sides in the second half, started wide on the right in the first half. He's now appeared wide on the left-hand side in the second. Nakamura playing a slightly wider role. It looks as though they've gone and pushed Soyoda through the centre in the second half to give them almost a 4-3-3 formation as they bid to get back into this.
I don't think they're having much joy. So they've obviously changed it. But at the moment, I think Aspire, obviously with the one goal lead, has set up very difficult to beat.
And I mean, the fact that Kashiwa are already through, you know, we talk about a winning mentality. They won't want to drop points here, will they? They want to keep their win going and be taking a run into the quarterfinals. You know, sides that win both games in the group carry that momentum forward into the knockout stages.
Yeah, they do. But I think they learned from the last time. You know, they did peak very early, and they were impressive when they came here. They've started off well, you know, and if they know themselves now as they move on, if they can get stronger. So a little slightly different approach from Kashiwa for me. A little bit more mature approach to this competition.
Coach checks his watch just down below us. Takanori Nunobe, he'll see that there are 53, just over minutes gone. Good play by Sully. He wants to keep hold of possession there. Salim Diaby. Weighing up his options, finds Carlos. The captain, Katana. So again, it breaks down though. Good tackling, a good challenging by Kashiwa Reysol. I think it gives you some idea of the scale of the size of the Aspire Football Dreams project. 500,000 young players so far have participated. Some 22,000 matches on 80 pitches throughout 18 countries. It really is an astonishing size of an initiative.
Well, it is, you know. And it, the rest of the world, or a lot of the world, you know, are thinking bad things about Qatar. It's not they put a lot of work in, you know, going to these third world countries, putting something like Aspire there to get the kids out, to try and make them into professional footballers. You know, the massive hubs they are, what they've got into, you know, and it deserves a lot of credit for what they've done. It's a fantastic thing what they're doing to give these lads the opportunity. You know, and they're grasping it. This is a way out for them. You know, and you can see it's one thing you need in football. It's always been a working class game. You know, it's about getting people and making them into something. And this is a big example of it. You know, this is, they want it. You know, they've got that hunger, even more than the probably Aspire, which is in Qatar, because it's a way to get out. It's something there for them. They can see it really means a lot.
Well, they're going to have to do some defending here, Aspire, because it's another Kashiwa free kick. They are going to make another change in a moment, Aspire. They're going to bring on Yemi Agboye. But for the moment, they have some defending to do. Very congested on the edge of the penalty area, and it comes straight into the wall. Not too sure that wall was back the full distance there. It's gone for a goal kick, so they haven't managed to capitalise.
But I was having a chat with somebody yesterday, and I just said, you know, with these players what come through the Aspire Football for Dreams here now, all of a sudden they get to a certain point, where do they go? Well, they get farmed out in Europe to a lot of the clubs. I think there's a club in Belgium in the second division, so, you know, there is a way through for them.
When you think of the amount of people that actually trial, I think something like 23 actually get onto the courses here out of maybe, you know, thousands and thousands. It's a bit like auditioning for a talent show on the TV, like an X Factor or something like that. You know, thousands of auditions, yet a very select handful get actually through to this stage. And that's why you assume these kids make the most of it, because they're one of the very select few.
Yeah, it's difficult. It's tough. You know, but they get there on a massive platform here. I mean, there's probably not, they might not make it to the very top, but they'll probably have some sort of football career. you know, because they learn all the basics, they learn how to be a professional. I suppose it's life skills as well. It's the it's the experience of coming abroad, playing, meeting other people.
Well, here comes the second change for Aspire Football Dreams. It's Andrei that's going off, and Yemi will be the player that comes on.
He's a handful. Andrei really is. You know, he's a centre forward there. He's got a trick, scores goals. I expected to have a big tournament.
Nice to see the coach there having a word. No players ever keen to be substituted, and I think Andrei there probably showing that a little bit, but the coach with a few reassuring words in his ear was nice to see.
That's what I said, that's how close they are.
That's a poor challenge by Quadri. He'll be lucky to escape a yellow card. Some treatment needed here for...
No, he just catches him, but what it is, because he's going at so much of a speed, you know, he can't really slow down, so he just catches him.
Tanaka actually got his, as he fell, he actually seemed to get his ankle caught underneath him, so much so that his boots actually come off. He could have ended up with quite a nasty ankle injury there had he fallen a little more awkwardly, but he seems to be okay. But just to recap, looking forward to tomorrow, Al Ahly against Real Madrid, the first game at 15:35 local time. It's Aspire Academy against Inter. What a game that'll be, both with big wins in their opening matches. And then Estudiantes, who led for a long time against Celtic today, taking on Red Bull Salzburg, who could be one of the dark horses in this competition, I reckon. Red Bull and maybe Al Ahly from what we've seen so far. The others, you know what you're going to get, your Real Madrid, your Inter Milans, but the others a little bit of an unknown quantity.
Yeah, Al Ahly, big performance. Can they go again tomorrow? Salzburg, you know they've got better in them. The coach has said that that's one of the worst performances, and we thought they played well. So a lot of really interesting games tomorrow. Inter Milan, can they do better than what we first saw? Can they go again? Can they, you know, how much can they keep improving in this tournament? You know, so there's so much questions what need to be answered. And tomorrow we're gonna see, but it's set up for another mouth-watering day of football.
I actually spoke to Marco Rose, the Salzburg coach, as they left after the first game, and said, you know, what did you think looking ahead to tomorrow? And he said, you know, Celtic proved that they had got them. That's what they were wary about in that opening game. I think that Celtic, when they got that goal, could have easily come back. And he said, that's what we were worried about. And I think that's what affected their play on the day, which is why they didn't play to their full potential. But every team here's a danger, you know, possibly with the exception of Shanghai and, well, PSG this year, maybe not, but anyway, another free kick to Kashiwa Reysol. Haven't really made the most of these set pieces as yet. It was a poor delivery from Achai, the substitute. Might come back to him. Looking busy in midfield, though, Aspire Football Dreams at the moment. Challenged by Yamashita. Forward by Sumar, scored that stunning goal and almost had a second one right on the stroke of half time. Another change about to be made here by Kashiwa Reysol. Tayo Namazuta is ready to come on. Mori, Tanaka, Nakagawa. That's a long ball over the top once again, but just carried a little bit too much pace from Yamashita.
Yeah, but once again at the moment, you know, Kashiwa aren't hurting Aspire. They're not hurting them at all. They're comfortable what they're doing. Eventually, you know, you give them the possession, then just like we saw then, they knock a ball which is too far. Just got to be very patient and disciplined, Aspire.
Sumar, Quadri, a little bit of space, he's got an overlap from Robert should he need him, he opts to come back inside, but the yellow shirts are back behind the ball once again. Suli had to get rid of it, he was under pressure from Nakamura. Here comes the change for the Japanese. Takumi Onodera is coming off. Can't remember mentioning his name too many times, which is possibly why he's being substituted. Tayo Namazuta is the player that comes on. Substitution for Kashiwa Reysol.
61 minutes on the clock. Aspire Football for Dreams still winning this, well, leading this game 1-0 against Kashiwa. A lot of possession from Kashiwa, but not really creating anything.
It's been a fairly tentative start by both sides to the second half. No goalkeeper, neither goalkeeper's been called into action as yet. I'm sure Aspire will want to get themselves another goal. They did lead 2-0 against Benfica, of course, so they're guaranteed that that's enough to get them the points. But don't forget, a draw would be good enough to put them through at the expense of the Portuguese into the quarterfinals.
You know, after tomorrow, it starts getting into the business end. Starts getting moving towards the quarters.
Final game of the group matches tomorrow. On Tuesday, we have the two matches between the four bottom sides, so the positions for 9 and 10 and 11 and 12 will be decided before we hit our first quarter final on Wednesday. Final, don't forget, will be on the 15th of February. Who will be crowned Alcas International Cup Champions 2016. Certainly won't be the defending champions Paris Saint-Germain, the two-time winners. They're heading out of the competition. Kashiwa are going to make another change. Kenta Tatsumi is the man coming on.
Good play.
So another striker.
Good play before, just down the left-hand side for Aspire. Sharp play. Kashiwa still trying to create something. They're not really doing it. A lot of football, but not creating.
Able to take his time before picking the ball up. Just waiting for Nakamura to get as close as he could. Running a few seconds off the clock. Yemi.
Just Katana. Just thinking now with Kashiwa, where is the goal going to come from? No, I'm just thinking it's not getting round the back. They're not, you know, they're not really. It's that exactly what we've been saying before. The final product.
Well, Kenta Tatsumi, that's coming on, is actually a striker, so maybe he's going a little bit more adventurous for the final quarter of the game. Tanakori Nonobo. We're going to see a change, but they'll wait to defend this free kick first before they make the substitution. This is one of those free kicks that will be whipped in towards the goalkeeper by Sully. Good punch.
Well done. Came out. Got the punch on it. He's a good keeper.
He's one of the tallest keepers I think we've got in the tournament. For Kubo. Hard to believe some of these players are still just 16 years of age. They are still growing as well, which is quite scary in some situations.
But they have to be, I think, in most of the leagues in the world. They're athletes, they're big, they're strong. You know, so it doesn't surprise me. I mean, they're all in great shape, all these lads here now. They've still got a lot of maturing, as in the body-wise, you know. They've still got a lot of change with the body. They're still, if they're all still only 16. You can see they're all in really good shape. You have to be now.
Great running by Diallo. Quadri still going. Quadri did well to stay on his feet. Looking for a grey shirt in the centre. Couldn't find one. Good defending again by Kashiwa. Robert. Quadri. Maybe a surprise he didn't start today for Aspire Football Dreams. Is Sumar weaving his way through? And the danger man once again firing over the top this time. And now we will see the substitution. It's Keito Mori, the midfielder, that's coming off, and a striker, Kenta Tatsumi, that's coming on.
Getting a lot of joy down here at the moment. Aspire on the left-hand side just finishes with a shot there with Sumar. Tries a bit of a toe pump, but it just goes over the bar. But if anything, you think, well, maybe Aspire might nick another goal.
It's that danger, isn't there? The longer the game goes on and things just get stretched with Kashiwa pushing forward, looking for an equaliser. Here's the substitute, Tatsumi. Namazuta. Ochai. Sioda, the man out wide. That's a poor ball back inside, though. It's cut out by Diallo. Nakagawa. Very good, assured player on the ball for a centre-back, Tatsumi. Back inside once again. Plenty of Aspire players back behind the ball, though.
Watch ball. Oh! Moving too late. Oh!
Kept in by Sugai.
No, no. Oh.
Yamashita. Looking wide again. That seems to be the plan. Tatsumi seemed to be taking this wide berth on the right-hand side. That's the two or three times now they've tried to pick him out with long balls. Nakagawa. Okamoto. It's the same as the first half, though, isn't it? They're having good possession, but they're not progressing very far at the moment. Tanaka.
Yep, this is what you've got to look out for. It's got to be an end product. It's difficult, all the football in the world, but you have to, got to have an end product. They're just struggling. I can't see them getting back into the game. You know, if anything, Aspire have got an end product. You know, when they get forward, they want to get a shot in. They want to get into the dangerous areas.
Perhaps the game's taking a similar pattern to the first game this afternoon, because at one point Celtic didn't look like getting back into it against Estudiantes, did they? But they got the equaliser, and all of a sudden it changed the whole complexion of the match. Nakamura, nice turn. Quickly closed down there. You see how hard Aspire Football Dreams are working at the moment. Tatsumi. He's got the overlap coming up from Tanaka. Pass was a little bit short, though, and Tanaka had to rush his cross with Quadri tracking him back. Pass wasted from the goalkeeper. I think he was trying to kick the ball out of play so the Aspire player could get some treatment.
No, he's not at all there. He's down at the moment, the player. And what he should have really done is just kicked it out, his own goalkeeper, but he's not done that.
Pretty certain when he went down initially, the play, he was right on the touchline. I think he's actually rolled back into play. Maybe that's why Kashiwa didn't want to kick the ball out, because it's Kashiwa's time, obviously, at the moment. Robert, the fullback, is the player that went down. Just get a look if we see the foul where it actually took place. Referee saw nothing wrong with it, allowed play to continue. 20 minutes to go. Aspire Football Dreams leading here by a goal to nil. Alex Garcia Canedo oversaw a draw in their opening match against Benfica. Going to make a change. Bibis is going to come on. There's the challenge. Well, there's a challenge. See, he's actually almost off the pitch. And he rolls off the pitch and then rolls back on the pitch. So I can understand Kashiwa's problem, maybe not putting the ball out of play. Robert, maybe slight overreaction, but he's back on his feet. Plays back in, well, the ball's back in play. Temporarily down to 10 men Aspire before the referee will call Robert back on. Raises his arm in the air. Good ball over the top. Oh, he's lost it. Had a real chance. And it goes just wide from Riku Ochai. And that's a great chance for Kashiwa, their best chance of the match so far.
Do you know that the first one in the first half was just a straight ball
long ball knocked forward, and they were nearly in, but it was given offside. This was the same thing. They didn't play the football, they just knocked it forward. And Riku Archai was there, and it's the best opportunity. So maybe go a little bit more direct.
I think he snatched at that. Just roll it maybe into the other corner might have been the better option, but...
Well, they can't deal with it. For some reason, it's just proved then if you knock a long ball, the two centre-halves are fine, having a lot of difficulty with it, so you've got to do more of it. But now they go back to playing the football. Knock a few long balls.
Lovely quick passing in the centre again by Kashiwa. Back by Tsutsumi to Nakagawa. That could have been the moment for the Japanese to level things up. Poor ball given away. Well read and cut out by Carlos. Striding forward, he's got one player in the centre to aim for, that's Yemi. Forward by Diallo. Brolin with a challenge, that'll be a free kick.
Nothing wrong with that, it's a good foul. When I say a good foul, otherwise you'd have seen Kashi were pushing up, maybe something would have happened. Sometimes you just got to bring someone down just to get all your players back and get back organised.
It's number 8, the goal scorer, Sumai, that's coming off, and Bibis, wearing 18, is coming on, so... Third change made by Aspire Football Dreams. 5 substitutions allowed, don't forget, during this under 17 competition. Just allows the coaches to freshen things up. It's good, isn't it, as well, if you've got impact players on the bench, you can actually change half your outfield lineup if you want to. If you've got those players on the bench, that can turn a game for you. Scored a great goal inside 2 minutes, Sumar. Almost had a second, had it not been for the brilliance of Leo Kakubo in the Kashiwa goal right on the stroke of half-time.
Yeah, what a strike it was as well. Wonderful goal.
Foul on Diallo.
It's been another good day again today of football.
Celtic beat Estudiantes in the opening game, 2-1, having trailed by a goal to nil. And Al Ahly from Saudi Arabia making their debut in the competition, beat the holders Paris Saint-Germain by 3-0. Nakamura.
But no support, and good defending as well there by Aspire. They break out with the ball and then work it down this right-hand side, but this left-hand side, sorry, but they give it away.
Thrown by Tanaka.
This is what the coach of Aspire was saying, you know, this is when he worries a little bit now, you know, about his discipline in his side. Got to keep switched on. Got to be careful of dropping too deep now. Can they force the ball up a little bit? Can they force the players up, condense it?
Tsutsumi again, the substitute, gives the ball away though. Sully defending, can't keep hold of the ball at the moment. Aspire, they won't care if the ball goes backwards here. Aspire, Nakagawa, Ochai. Ball over the top, looking forwards, the run of Sugai. Good defending. Soyoda with a throw. Okamoto. Nakagawa. Chipped over the top for the run of Tanaka. Did well to get the ball across. It's a good one as well. Goalkeeper claims it. Not the tallest player in the world, Nakamura, to challenge.
Yeah, that's the thing as well, because they're not that tall up front. When they do put a cross in, it's got to be something special if they're going to get on the end of it, and that's why they just soak it all up. But once again, still the question mark for me, you know, is that end product, can they create something?
Daisuke Sadahiro is about to come on, so it will be a fourth change made by Kashiwa Reysol. Now, Kato, of course, in the starting lineup. He was sent off in the game against Benfica yesterday, serving out a one-match suspension. He will be available for the knockout stages, though. Robert on the run again, chased by Tatsumi.
Well done by Robert. Lovely play that was. Upper body strength. Keeping hold of the ball, running down the line.
Norihiro Soyoda is the player that's going off. And as we said, Daisuke Sadahiro is the player coming off. Minutes to go. Spire Football Dreams still leading by a goal to nil, scored as early as the second minute by Sumar, one of the goals of the tournament. Still have to go soon to beat Marco Sala's goal for Inter, though, on the opening day. Sumar's goal was the 37th we've seen so far in 9 matches.
Good play as well, then, just a minute ago from Aspire. I know Kashiwa tried to stop them from playing out of the back, but it didn't affect Aspire. They still managed to get it into midfield. Don't need to foul on the halfway line. Kashiwa with a free kick. Just over 10 minutes remaining.
Right in front of the Japanese flags over on the far side. Foul on Nakamura. Okamoto.
The coach of Aspire there shouting to his team, telling them, giving them instructions.
Need someone to step up, Kashiwa, if they are to get anything from this game. The clock is ticking. Spire have done their job exceptionally well so far, just cut out the threat in midfield. A couple of times they have been caught out by the long ball, but managed to survive so far. Nakagawa. There's that long diagonal once again. Goalkeeper's come a long way out here, taken on the chest by Nakamura. Couldn't quite bring it down under control. Okamoto's header. Namazuta, pushed out wide by Nakamura. Sugai. You hear the coaching staff from Aspire telling their players to push higher up the field.
Yeah, they're dropping as the game goes on now. They're really dropping. You've got to keep your discipline. And once again, you know, the ball was a long pass again from Kashiwa. Nearly went in, nearly got in. Got to keep doing it. It seems to be the only bit of joy they're getting at the moment. Probably about 3 different times in the game they managed to get through just from a straight long pass.
Well, they're trying to stretch the back four of Aspire at the moment. They are playing more 4-3-3. They've pushed Tanaka up wide on the right-hand side now, and he's looking to drag Robert out to this side, which might leave Nakamura a little bit of space through the centre.
Yeah, they're trying to get something out of the game now. They're upping the tempo.
Okamoto given away cheaply to Carlos. Okamoto. A cushion header back inside for Tatsumi. Foot was high though, it'll be a free kick to Aspire. That's one of those just a coming together. Felt the full force of that though, Salim Diaby. He'll need a little bit of treatment possibly before he can continue.
It was a full-blooded challenge. There was a bit of a chance that he could have kicked the bottom of the boot. It was there to be won.
The golf cart's coming up.
There we go.
right at the
Can
edge.
I just tell you, it's never been on all throughout today, and same as last night, it comes on. We're in the 81st minute of the third game, and the cart decides to come on. Perhaps what's it doing throughout the day?
Probably on charge.
It doesn't seem until the end.
Someone forgot to plug it in last night. Well, we've got this opportunity. I mean, we've seen all 12 teams now. Who has most impressed you of the 12 teams we've seen so far?
In different ways, I would have to say Real Madrid, Inter Milan in the first game. And I've got to say as well, Al Ahly today. I thought they've whether they could go on and do something, but just impressed me. It's a big result, that, against Paris Saint-Germain. So I like them, but I would like to. I'm looking forward to seeing more of Real Madrid. You know, strong, organised, good at the back. You know, they score goals as well. So,
well, it is Real Madrid against Al Ahly tomorrow, so we get the chance to see the Saudi side in action almost immediately.
I just hope with them, you know, it's not a lot of time really for recuperation and really in getting a. It's just short. If they were playing probably later in the day, might have given them a little bit more of a chance. So we'll have to see.
Spire Academy against Inter Milan and Estudiantes de la Plata against Red Bull Salzburg are the other two games tomorrow. Yamashita into the final 10 minutes, well into the final 10 minutes now, in fact. Robert defended very well at fullback. He's been under a lot of pressure from Tatsumi and now from Sadahiro, but he's managed to do his job well. And he wins a throw for his side right in the corner as well. No, off.
Move it on. Just getting into the last 6 or 7 minutes now. Kashiwa have got to try and do something, got to try and get the ball forward. Are they going to send any more players forward? I mean, they don't need it, but obviously want to try and get back into the game, definitely.
Because it's the time as well, with Kashiwa having played yesterday. I know they made a lot of changes, but with the substitutions, there are plenty of players on that featured yesterday. And they usually start getting a little tired in the last few minutes. That's where errors can creep in. This man still looks strong on the ball, though, Nakagawa. Tanaka. Okamoto. Ochai. Brought down. Clumsy challenge. No real need to commit and give the foul away there. And both players are down injured. Couldn't really do much to get out of the way there.
Just turned round and the players were coming in that quickly behind him. I just caught him.
Clattered into by Katana, the captain. The cart's on again.
Still good performances anyway. Again, it's another good performance again from Aspire. Looking forward to seeing these as it moves on further in the stages. Both sides.
Well, it's highly unlikely you would think that Kashiwa are going to score twice, so it means that both these sides will go through in the competition. Kashiwa would win the group, which will mean they'll play the side that finishes second in the Real Madrid Al Ahly group. We'll know the outcome of that tomorrow. Whoever finishes second in this group will play the team that finishes top. At the moment, that's Real Madrid on goal difference, but of course everything could change when they play Al Ahly tomorrow. Here comes the free kick from Namazuta. Great delivery, but a good header by Sully. Everybody back for Aspire. Trying to get Robert Diallo back on. Played back by Carlos to his goalkeeper, Manf. Okamoto's header. Well,
to get it forward. There you go. Look at the ball. It's a perfect ball. There's a good opportunity here now. Got to get it in the box. It's got to go in the box.
Tanaka plays it short.
Once again, it has to go in. Straight away, you know, that little bit of space opened up there. Whip it in. Too much football. Now there's a chance. It's opened up. Unlucky.
It's Namazuta that slipped the ball through. Unfortunately, couldn't pick out the run of Nakamura, who was the furthest man forward. Close. 3 minutes to go then, the final game of the day. And the final game. In Group B. Benfica look as though they will be contesting the playoff for 9th and 10th place. The 11th and 12th place will be between Shanghai Greenland and Paris Saint-Germain on Tuesday. Benfica's opponents will come from the Salzburg Celtic Estudiantes group. Could be a tight one, because if Estudiantes do manage to reach Salzburg tomorrow, then they'll be on 3 points each, which means we may have to get the calculators out. One way to go, though, before we reach that eventuality. Here come Aspire looking for a second, which surely would kill off the game. Shot took a deflection, but it deflects off an Aspire player and goes behind for a goal kick. And that flicked off Bibis, I think. Sadahiro. Tanaka Sadahiro. Oh, it's a late challenge again by Diallo. The referee just waited to see if there was an advantage, but it is a free kick and a chance for them to get the big men forward. Nakagawa and Okamoto both making their way towards the edge of the penalty area. Needless challenge, really, in that sort of area. And it really has put his defence under pressure now. That little dive in from Diallo. It's all about the delivery, though, from Namazuta. Into the final minute of the 90, just a question of whatever the stoppages are added on by the fourth official on this near side, which we'll see in just a moment. But here comes Namazuta's free kick. Plenty of movement inside the penalty area. Can't miss out that first man once again. Bibis. Now there might be a break on here. Lovely ball played over the top by Katana. Quadri, he's got a man racing through the centre. Yemi's all on his own in the middle. Quadri might go on his own. It's Yemi with a chance to make it two and wrap up the points. It's offside. It wouldn't have counted anyway. Katana had strayed offside, and that's a glorious opportunity for Aspire to wrap this one up with Kashiwa pushing players forward. Not to be, though. Can Kashiwa still come and get a late equaliser? There will be 4 minutes added time. That's a long ball over the top. That's a wasted one, though. Straight away, Riku Ochai shows his displeasure in the fact that he put too much on the pass. Surely Aspire will just want to try and hang on to the ball now. Keep it in the corners. Run the clock down. Make sure that Kashiwa can't get any more opportunities to score. But they're making a brave fist of it coming forward again. Away by Robert. Nice play once again. It's a decent looking cross, but it didn't quite get the curl on it to keep it in play. And again, another frustrating ball in from Hayate Sugai. Hadi, hadi.
Hey, up, up. Move it, move it, move it. Up. Hey, here, 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 here. Go.
Okamoto just caught slightly out of position, but just managed to get enough on the header to guide it to Nakagawa's central defensive partner. Here is Nakagawa. Sadahiro. Long ball over the top. Sully could just duck underneath that one, allow it to go back to his goalkeeper, Manf. Defended well in the second half, Aspire, although they haven't really been threatened by Kashiwa. That one chance that fell to Riku Ochaile, Tom, when he hooked the ball wide, when it was a glorious opportunity through the central area. Ochai. It's another free kick to Kashiwa, and it's a yellow card for Carlos. Tanaka. Now Mazuta. One last chance, maybe. Across it comes. The header down, white four here. There's still a chance. He's still on for the shot. But it's into the side netting from Ochai once again. But it has taken a slight deflection and gone for a corner. But it really opened up for Kashiwa. There was the header back. That's great work by Brolin, rather, who may have got the touch on that. Great tackle. So two chances really that Ochai has had in this second half for Kashiwa. But there's still some defending here to do for Aspire. We've got a few seconds of the added time to go. This could be the final opportunity for the Japanese to get themselves level. They are going through though, don't forget. Overcomes the cross, goalkeeper keeps an eye on it. Well taken by Manf. The big Ghanaian goalkeeper plucks that one from the air. Just finds himself a little bit of space in the penalty area to run a few more seconds off the clock. And Alex Garcia Canedo's side are going through to the next stage of the competition. They have won it. That very early goal from Sumar. A stunning strike from some 30 yards out with just 2 minutes gone. And that's the way that it stayed. Aspire had a couple of chances. Never really looked like getting another goal. Leo Kakuba made a fine save, though, from Sumar right on the stroke of half-time. Manf wasn't really tested. A couple of chances for Ochai in the second half for Kashiwa, but having made six changes, it was a vastly different side for them. But they were safely through after they win over Benfica yesterday, and they go into the quarter-finals. It's Aspire Football Dreams that top the group. 4 points out of six for them. Kashiwa Reysol finished second. Benfica prop up the group. Both those are through. The winners will play the second-place team in the Real Madrid Al Ahly group, while the second-place team will also play the second team in the same group. That just about rounds us off for today. It's been another fantastic day here at Aspire Zone. All the reaction to come. The full-time score in the final game of the day. It's finished Aspire Football Dreams 1, Kashiwa Reysol 0. We'll be right back.
انضم إلى برنامج Global Recognition من أوائل QNB وتمتع بعالم من الخدمات المصرفية المميزة، خدمة عالمية تقدم لك امتيازات حصرية تعزز نمط حياتك أينما كنت وفي أي وقت، تجعلك تتحكم في معاملاتك وحساباتك، تمكنك من امتلاك منزل جديد في الخارج مع خدمة التمويل العقاري الدولي. برنامج Global Recognition من أوائل QNB، عالم الامتيازات الحصرية.
My hero, one of my country's most talented players. Nowadays, talent alone is not enough. Football has changed. There is a place where you can get world-class coaching that pushes you to train harder and harder. Education that helps build your future. Sports science that enhances your performance. And where you are always in the right hands. This place has found me, and I am ready. One day, I want to be his hero.
Aspire Academy. Aspire today. Inspire tomorrow.
أنا خدوتي لما أكبر أصير نفس نيمار. في 2022 أبي أكون في استاد البيت.
عم نشوف جمهور في ملعب اللاعبين.
كأس العالم 2022 هو البداية.
تشكيلة متنوعة من البرامج لكل العائلة، أحدث الأفلام والمسلسلات والبرامج الترفيهية وأفضل البرامج الوثائقية والإخبارية وبرامج الأطفال وأقوى الفعاليات الرياضية الحصرية. كما يمكنك مشاهدة هذه البرامج في أي وقت وأي مكان. وهل تعلم ما هو سعر الاشتراك؟ أليس هذا مدهشاً؟
Aspire football dreams just beat Takasho Reysol 1-0, which means that they finish top of Group B. Let's get reaction now, head pitch side, and join Wissam.
Rod, I have by my side Garcia, coach of Aspire Dream. Coach, beautiful game, 1-0, it's enough to be the lead the group. Tell me, how did you see the performance of your team today?
Today was a strong game. Today, same as 2 days ago against Benfica, it was a very, very equal game. Both teams had very few chances. In the end, the most effective team is the one that wins.
You satisfied from what the players are giving till now?
I'm more than satisfied. I'm Masruru jiddan jiddan.
Tell me, what's the next point now? What are you going to concentrate on? What?
Right now, go back to the hotel, relax, disconnect, and we'll see who we're playing against next game.
I have also by my side the best player, the most valuable player in the game, Al-Hassani. Tell me, your feeling, you happy, satisfied?
Yes, je suis très content aujourd'hui là, parce que j'ai bien joué. Parce que depuis lorsqu'on est venu ici, tout le monde qui est concentré pour jouer.
He says he's very happy because he played a good game and the team is together and we're playing as a team.
All the best, guys. Thank you so much.
Shukran, shukran.
Rod, that's all what we have till now. Back to you.
Thank you very much indeed. Well, he can be satisfied and he deserves to go back to the hotel, all of them, and disconnect, as he says. Chris Makin and Nick Summerby alongside me. Why are you looking at me a bit puzzled?
He's
there?
Been disconnected a few times. So.
I have to say that was a line I was looking to say, but I thought I wouldn't. Listen, fantastic. It was a fantastic game. Like the game against Benfica, two strong teams. But they deserve to win that one.
Yeah, I think they've got more individual flair. It was a great game. The pace of the game didn't stop for the whole 90 minutes, considering that they had nothing to play for apart from who's going to finish first or second. But great pace of the game, but no chances, hardly any chances in the second half. So, I mean, I expected it before the game because there were so many changes, 9 changes between both sides. So I expected the level to go down in terms of chances being created.
And you I think Aspire can create opportunities. Yeah. I just worry it's nice football, but I don't think they create anything. It's that final third. They've got to start getting that into the game.
Up until that final third, football is absolutely superb. Perfect, yeah. They knock it about and it's fizzed about the football pitch like you wouldn't believe. But there's no,
There's nothing at all. You've got to have that if you're going to further yourself. Listen, great football, but no. Not for me. I think Aspire have got that little bit more of an edge on him.
This was the goal, Suma, as early as the second minute. It was an absolute beauty, and it'll be in the basket of top goals. Loved it, Chris Makin.
It was a wonderful goal. Great vision. I said before about having pictures in your head, knowing what you're going to do before you receive the ball, and he knew exactly what he was going to do. Touch out with his feet, and it's a superb strike. Look at the dip and the pace on the ball. Great goal.
It's definitely up there, that Rod, as I've got to tell you now. It's a wonderful strike.
And it was just that one chance we picked out to discuss in that second half, and it fell to Kashiwa Reysol. It was a great opportunity. Again, the captain, Chris, was involved in it.
Yeah, like I said, there was hardly any chances in the second half. We went down, had a little walk, went to pitch side to watch the players in action close up. Great pace to the game, but nothing in terms of chances for either side, really.
I promised it to you, Chris, and here it is.
Yeah, he was onside, and he does everything right. It's a great run, pulls off the last defender, keeps the ball down, just misses the target, doesn't he, Nick?
Their only opportunities they've had are from long balls, you know, and maybe they bring that into the game a little bit, you know, because, and I'll tell you something as well, Aspire can't deal with it. You see, look at the centre half there, he doesn't know what he's doing, but that's just a pretty much straight ball. So they've got to try and bring a little bit of that in there, and that could be a way for other teams to be able to get it Aspire.
Okay, we've had 3 fantastic games once again on day 3. 7 goals in total, and we'll see them all next.